On the River Ribble, 10 miles before it reaches the Irish Sea, Preston is a former market town granted city status in 2002. In the 14th century, Flemish weavers settled in Preston, establishing a textile industry that would power the economy until the mid-20th century. Let's explore the best places to visit in Preston. Number 1. Harris Museum and Art Gallery. Preston's City Museum and Art Gallery is in a striking neoclassical hall inaugurated in 1893. The first thing you'll see when you enter is a Foucault pendulum, demonstrating the rotation of the earth, and also a working clock. The museum has awesome collections of natural history, textiles, costumes, ceramics, and other decorative art. Number 2. Avenham and Miller Parks. Two of the northwest of England's most refined Victorian parks, the Avenham and Miller Parks, are side by side, flowing down to the Ribble to the south of Preston Railway Station. The pair were designed by the prominent Victorian landscape architect Edward Milner in the 1860s and are separated by the embankment for the defunct East Lancashire Railway. Number 3. Ribble Steam Railway. On an industrial estate near the Preston Docks, the Ribble Steam Railway is a combined museum and functioning heritage railway line. The railway uses track that laid down for the docks and runs for just over a mile along the Ribble River to Strand Road. Number 4. Church of St. Walburge. Preston's Grade I listed Gothic Revival Church went up in the middle of the 19th century and was built by Joseph Handsome. He also designed the Handsom cab, which revolutionized horse-drawn transport in Victorian times. St. Walburge's is renowned for having the tallest spire of any parish church in the country, at 94 meters tall. Number 5. Winkley Square. One of the prettiest places in Preston is this Georgian square, intended as a residential quarter for the city's upper crust at the turn of the 19th century. Winkley Square is at the heart of a conservation area and is fronted mostly by long terraces of Georgian townhouses, which are especially grand on the north and west borders. Number 6. Preston North End FC. The local football club is a team with serious heritage. Preston North End was established in 1880 and was one of the 12 founding members of the Football League, which played its first season in 1888-89. Preston North End won both the league and the FA Cup in 1888-89, still the most successful season in the club's history. Number 7. Guild Wheel. The Burgesses, freemen of the borough of Preston, were bestowed the right to hold a guild merchant, a kind of fair, by King Henry II in 1179. From 1328, this took place every 20 years, and there was an unbroken sequence of celebrations from 1542 to 1922, spoiled only by the Second World War. Number 8. Preston Cenotaph. The designer of the UK's iconic red telephone boxes, Sir Giles Gilbert Scott, was responsible for Preston's monument to its first World War dead. The cenotaph was unveiled on Market Square in 1926, and its inscription was later revised to include those who perished in the Second World War. Number 9. Lancashire Infantry Museum. Anyone inspired by military history should call in at this museum, which is the largest repository of regimental history in the North England. The location is half the appeal, in the active, but soon to be decommissioned Fulwood Barracks, a group of solemn sandstone buildings built in the 1840s. Number 10. Moor Park. The largest and oldest park in the city, Moor Park is north of Preston's centre next to the Deepdale Stadium. It is claimed to be the first municipal park established in England's nascent industrial towns in the 19th century. Previously, this had been common land, a holdover from the medieval royal forest of Fulwood. Hope you like this video. For more videos, please subscribe to our channel.